Welcome to the lecture on building materials. Today, in this lecture, we will learn about Islam. So we get this one from the query. So first of all, we try to learn what is the meaning by query. The query is nothing but it is a place from where we generally get the Islam. It can be a rock, or it can be any kind of pit, or it can be any kind of mine which is open to the sky. So any kind of the structure from where we get this one, that is usually known as the query. And the process of getting this one from that query is known as the query. So what is the query? It is query is the place from which the dimensions from rock, construction aggregate, or to say repair, sand, gravel, or to say the slag that is excavated from the ground. A query is the same thing as an open pit mine from which the minerals are extracted. So, what is stone? Stone can be anything. It can be that dimension, a stone which is already shaped, or the rock, or it can be construction aggregate, repair, or sand, gravel. All those things are generally classified under the category of stones. So, the types of rock that is extracted from the quarry includes all these things are the types of the stones. And we have different kinds of stones like chalk, then the China clay, then we have cinder, then we have clay, gall, the construction aggregate, and that is usually used the sand or the gravel. Then we have the diabase, then gabbro, granite, brittle stone, gypsum, and limestone. And at last, marbles, ores, phosphate rock, sandstone, and last layer. All these are will classify as this one. We will learn about this one as far as they are concerned for the building. The many query, the stones such as marble, granite, limestone, sandstones are there to be cut into a larger slab. And then we generally use them as, and then we generally divide them as per requirement, as per the requirement of shape and size, as per those requirements, we generally cut all this query and then we use it. But while getting it from query, we generally get it into a larger slab. And most of the query, after getting the stones and material from the query, what will happen? There will a leveling area will be formed at those places, at the place of query. So either these places from where already the quarry has been taken out, so those areas become like abundant area. So like those areas can be used like as a lake also, or sometimes if it is nearby to the city or it is outside the city, those places can be used for the landfill purpose, also. This the picture shows one of the quarry site photo. We can see from this side it's showing the rock. That we can get the idea that this site earlier the rock may be there. After quarrying, the material which has been taken out, this area has been converted into the low-lying area. This area might be having certain catchment area. So the water, it has been collected, the water after rainy season, and this has been converted into a lake. While we can see that surrounding we are having the rock still. So this is what the abundant area which is here. This abundant area after quarrying has been used as a lake. It also showing the same kind of, here we can see this is the square site. Here we can see from here we have already taken the material, and still the rock is still some rock is available there. From there we are taking the stone from there. Similarly, we can see in this picture, this from here the material has been taken out already after blasting or by some other methods, and this area they are using this area as a pond. Still the water has been filled in that area. So, how to get this one from the rock? We have different methods of quarrying, that is to the method, as we have already discussed, the process of getting this one from the rock is known as the quarry. So, we have different methods of quarrying, that is how to get this one from the rocks. We have the rock blasting method as well as we have the digging method. So, we have having two methods. One is what we are seeing here, the rock blasting. Second one is what we have, that is the digging. So first of all, we are learning about the rock blasting method. In the rock blasting method, what we will do? the name is we use the explosive the material or some the either we use the explosive material or some kind of gas pressure we will generally use, okay, so I do for the blasting purpose. What we are seeing here, the log blasting is controlled use of explosive and the methods such as gas pressure blasting or pyrotechnics or the plasma processes to excavate, break down or remove the rocks generally. And then it is practiced most often in generally mining or quarrying and the civil engineering structures such as dam or road construction. We generally use the log blasting method.
As the fire from outside,
inside. This is the explosive material. We will try to burn, so it will create a pressure, and there will be no place for the use of this pressure. So this pressure will help in the breaking of that rock, and we will get this rock, and we will get the broken pieces of stone. So this is what the rock class. What we are doing? We are trying to find out the holes for the weak or the weak area within the rock, or some kind of fissures where we can charge the explosive material. What is the charging of explosive material? It is nothing but to just fill that material within. It is just to insert that explosive material. How to say that is the gunpowder dynamite within that, and then do the damping, means fix it properly, damp it, and then do the firing from outside. As it will be fired, if it try to blast inside, so it will create a pressure. Once the pressure will be beyond the handling capacity of the rock, it will be converted into a blast, and we will get the broken pieces of this stone. This is the rock blasting method of stone. Now we will move to the second one, that is digging method. Here, what we will do in digging method, it is done by driving the steel wedges. Here also we will apply the same techniques. We use the steel wedges into and these steel wedges will be driven into the deep portion of the rock. Where will be the where at what places the rock will be the places where already existing holes are there, or where the fissures are present, or the cracks are present. That is the and the plane of the wedges. These are known as the weak points of the rock. So we try to find out these weak places, and we hit on these weak places only. So after identifying these places, the steel wedges will be driven into this, and then we will put the pressure from outside, and we will try to break the broken pieces of stone. That is what we generally do in the digging method. This is the first method or the first type. This also is one of the type of getting the stones from the rock. That is why you are driving the steel wedges. Then the next one is what? Sometimes the line of holes are drilled with the help of chisel and hammer. Sometimes if there is not a proper cracks are not developed there, but we have the hair lines also. The hair line is also a place where which indicating the weak area only or the weak portion on the rope. So we try to develop the fissures there. The artificial, we will try to develop the artificial fissures. So those hairline cracks will be developed into the proper cracks. So for that we will use the chisel and the hammer. The chisel is nothing but a nail kind of structure of this kind. So this structure will be driven with the help of hammer into the it will be hitted on that portion of hairline with the help of hammer. So it will try to develop the artificial fissure at the time. So once this artificial fissure will be developed, after that again the steel wedges will be driven into that portion, and the same process will be followed that what we have discussed in the first point. That is what this is the second type or the second what we can say the time to get the stones. What it is here? Sometimes the line of holes are drilled with the help of chisel and hammer. Thus the solidity of rock mass is divided into the small portion, and the artificial fissures are made so that the steel wedges are drilled simultaneously, and consequently the rope breaks along the face of fissure. Or the swollen are wooden cracks that are driven either natural or man-made fissures and are kept stocked with the water. So here what we will try to do at the place of the steel wedges, here we will use the wooden cracks. The same kind of method will be followed. Either already as you have find out the weak portion of the rope, like the cracks or some kind of fissures or the plane of cleavages, already these places are already available. So these are the weak portion. Directly we will try to drive the wooden cracks into that. If these places are not available or some kind of hairline cracks are available, then we have to make the artificial fissures, or we have to develop or we have to increase the weaker portion, or we have to say we have to make the weak portion much weaker. In the same method as we are discussing point number 2, once the already natural the fissures are developed, or we have developed artificial the fissures into those fissures, the wooden pack will be driven. Once the wooden pack will be driven, the another end of that wooden pack will be soaked into the water, or we will supply the water from the another end of the wooden pack. So what will happen? That due to as that wood will be in the presence of water, there will be swelling within the bone, and as there will be swelling within the bone, it will exert the pressure on the brain within the rock. So due to that pressure, we will get the rock into the broken pieces. So that is also one of the method of getting this one from the rock. So we have two methods here of the swelling. One is method we have discussed, that is rock casting method, and another one is digging. In digging, we have learned the three techniques which we will use in the different situations. So this is the other methods of swelling in the stomach. Then we have the next step, that is dressing. What is the dressing? The dressing is nothing but to get the stone in the required size and shape as per the requirement. In the general meaning, or in the general language, the meaning of the dressing is nothing but it is just to get or to convert the existing stone or the available stone in the required size and shape as per the requirement. That is generally known as the dressing of the stone. So what it is? Yes, the dressing of stone is the process in which their surface are prepared to a form or fit to be used for any construction purposes. Dressing is according to the work and demand. That's what we are discussing. It is nothing but to get the stone into the required shape and size as per the requirement. So what will be the purposes for dressing? That we have in the list three main purposes for the dressing. That is what? To give them good looking. Obviously, if somewhere if we have a sharp angle, something else, it won't look good. So if you are and you want to use that kind of stone somewhere and the mass boundary somewhere else, so we will just go for the cutting. So we will try to improve its appearance, then to provide horizontal and vertical joints in the mass boundary. Other than that, to make them fit to be used for a particular construction. And we have the types of dressing. Generally we have two types of dressing. Two methods for the dressing. One is the rough dressing, and then we have the paired dressing. So we have the two methods what we can use for the dressing, that is rough dressing and the paired dressing. Let's discuss first of all the rough dressing. Within the rough dressing also we have the two methods. One is the scabbling. One is scabbing and another one is hammer dressing. So still we have the two types of dressing. There is one is mainly the rough dressing and then paired dressing. Within the rough dressing also we have the two methods, that is scabbling and hammer dressing. What is scabbling? Scabbling is nothing but it is only irregular angles are taken off from the only irregular angles are taken off by the help of scabbling hammer. And why the hammer dressing? It is nothing but the stones are hammered to obtain the desired angles. So means in this, if already some we have some sharp angle, something else, if some kind of sharp angle or some bad kind of angle is available is present in this stone, then we try to remove those kind of angles with the help of hammer. That's what we do in scabbling. While in the hammer dressing, we generally try to develop the angles within this stone as per our requirement. And then we have the second type, that is what the paired dressing. The paired dressing is also done at the building site. In this we have the method, that is the chisel dressing. What we do in the chisel dressing, about one and one fourth about 1 inch one inch surface from all the side is generally removed from all the sides. So obviously from all the four sides of pieces, whatever is available, so that to provide a better appearance or to provide a proper kind of smooth surface on all the sides. That's what we do generally in chisel dressing. Then we have the deterioration of building stones. We have several factors which deteriorate the building stones. We'll just learn each and every one by one. First of all, let's see in the rain. The rain causes both the physical and chemical actions on the stone. What are the physical actions? The alternative wetting and drying. What happens? As we know, due to rain, the rain causes wetting it will not be a continuous process. Someday it will be running, it will just wait this long, and then the drying will be then it will then sun will cause the drying, and again then sometime again it will be raining some other day, it will again cause the wetting, then the drying due to sun. So if we have the alternate cycle of wetting and drying due to sun and alternate cycle of wetting and drying due to the raining and sun, and this causes the internal strain within the storm, and this internal strain causes the stress, and therefore it sometimes causes the crack within the storm. Then we have the chemical actions. In the industrial area, the acidic drain water reacts. In the industrial area, the acidic drain generally causes of building stone. There are several factors which affects, which causes the deterioration of building stone. Well, let's learn each and everyone one by one. First of all, let's take the rain. What the rain water will generally affect the, it will be deteriorates the stone physically and chemically. What is the physical action? It generally causes, it is nothing but alternate wetting and drying. What happens as the in raining season? It causes the wetting of stone. As the rain will not be continuous for all the season, again the sun will cause the drying. Again, some other day, the raining, it will again cause the wetting of stone. So there will be continuous, or the, precisely there will be alternate wetting and drying of the stone. So what it do, it generally created the internal strain within the stone, and this internal strain causes the stress, and that causes the, and that results further in the cracking of the stone. Or to say the deterioration of stone. Then we have the chemical actions. What it do? In the industrial area, the acidic drain generally acidic drain water reacts with the constituents of the stone and lead to its disintegration. The best example of this chemical action, or to say the acidic drain, that is the change in color at Taj Mahal. Then we have the next one, that is this was the frost. Then we have the second, that is frost. What it do in the air, in generally cold places, the frost penetrates into the pores of the stone, where it freezes and expands and results into the crack. How? In generally, what in the cold places, the frost penetrates into the pores of the stone. And this whatever moisture will be available, that will be converted into the ice rocks. And this, once it will be converted due to the freezing temperature, this moisture will be converted into the ice rocks, it will be converted into the ice cubes. And once it will be converted into ice cubes, there will be attraction force in between these particles, and there will form these ice cubes will be attracted towards each other. And once it will be attracted towards each other, the ice cubes will form ice lancers. Similarly, here also it will form somewhere. These ice cubes will form the ice lancer, or the grown size of the ice cubes will be converted into ice lancer. As it will be converted into ice lancer, their volume will increase, and as their volume will increase, it will put the pressure, it will exert the pressure on the internal side. As it will insert the pressure, and due to this pressure, their cracks may develop within the stone, and it will cause the deterioration of the building stone. Then we have the wind. What it causes? It causes the generally wind carries the sand particle or the dust particle. The soil particles. So as the wind carries this soil particle, dust particle, sand particle, and as it is carrying this stone particle, it comes into the contact with the stone, and due to the abrasion, it causes the deterioration of the stone. And the temperature changes, we can see the expansion and contraction due to different changes. The little different change in temperature causes the deterioration within the stone. How? We have the temperature change. It may be the daily variation, or it may be the seasonal variation. Within the day also, we know that during morning, we will have a certain temperature. During the noon, the temperature will increase, and then in evening, temperature will further decrease, and in night, temperature will further decrease. So it causes the daily temperature variation. Similarly, we have the different seasons. We have rainy season, we have winter season, we have summer season. So in winter season, there will be the temperature differential will be something else. Similarly, in summer season, the temperature differential will be something else. Similarly, in rainy season, temperature differential will be something else. So it causes the seasonal variation in temperature. This daily and seasonal variation in temperature causes the expansion and contraction within the stone. And this causes the temperature strain and temperature stressor, and that results in the deterioration of the stone. Then we have the vegetable growth. What happens? Generally, the roots of the tree and weed that grows in the masonry joints, it keeps the stone damp. Damp means it will keep the stone wet. As they will be wet for a longer time, what will happen? The durability of that stone will reduce. As the durability will be reduced, obviously there will be deterioration of the stone. And also it also generates the organic and acidic matters, which chemically affects it and also reduces its durability and results in the deterioration of the stones. Then we have the chemical agents, there is smog, fumes, acids, whatever present in atmosphere also deteriorate the stones. Sometimes if the stone is containing the MgCO3 are badly affected. That is, the limestone are also badly affected due to these things. Then we have the lichens, these lichens badly destroy the limestone. So the example of limestone can be the marble. So they destroy the limestone badly, but they can act as a protective force for other kind of stones. We have some of the pictures of these deteriorations. We can see this Taj Mahal color deterioration. This could be, we can understand that this marble used to be white in color, but it has been converted into the yellow color. It can be due to the acidic rain, or we can say the chemical effect of the acids. We can see the lichen effects. This is nothing but lichens. So what like we can see, this is nothing but the lichens. It is also keeping the stone in damp condition, and then later on the durability of this stone will reduce. We can see here the vegetable growth of the trees or the weeds within the masonry joints. We can see the stone is looking very rough from this side. due to the wind which carry the stone, due to the wind which carry the sand particle, soil particle, dust particle, which causes the abrasion with the stone surface, and due to this abrasion it becomes, if this adjustment, it becomes a very rough surface. This also kind of deterioration. This is due to wind. This you can see the change in color. The drawing or whatever design has been deteriorated. This also kind of deterioration, maybe due to some chemical effect. This also kind of deterioration. So this is all about this one. Now let's start a new topic, that is the timber. Let's understand first of all what is the cross section, different terminology, what we use in timber. Here we can see, here if it takes, suppose this is a wooden log, then this round, this represents this portion of the wooden or the wooden log, and this is the grain direction, this is known as the grain direction. So this cross section is moving. It's representing this cross section AA of this work. The center part of this wooden log of this timber, this is generally known as pitch. Here, this outer side, this is generally outer part, while this is the internal one. This is the internal part or the inner part, this outer part. Well, this one is, this is the inner part or internal part. This is the pitch, right? These are the round, these rings, these rings are nothing but they are the annual, these are called as annular rings, right? This rings of internal area of, these are called this, the shape up to this internal area up to this one, these are generally called hardwood, right? The outer rings or outer annular annular rings are generally called the slabwood, and these lines, these are generally called the rails, and this is the grain direction. This is the grain direction. So this is they are generally general term related to timber. That is pitch, the center part, then this outer block, internal one is inner part. These are the annular rings. Internal annular rings are generally called the hardwood. Outer annular rings are called the slabwood. While these lines or these hairs are called the rails, and this is the grain direction. So let's learn first in the paper what is this meaning. Seasoning is nothing but it is a process by which the moisture content is reduced so that durability of the timber can be increased. So what is seasoning? Seasoning is nothing but it is a process of reduction of moisture content so that the durability of the timber can be increased. What is seasoning? Seasoning is a process by which moisture content in a freshly cut tree is reduced to a suitable level. By doing so, the durability of timber is increased. We have two methods mainly for this, that is the natural seasoning and the artificial seasoning. We have two methods of this seasoning, that is one is the natural one and then we have the artificial seasoning. We have two, within this natural seasoning also we have again two methods within this natural seasoning, that is one is the air seasoning. In this natural seasoning also we have two methods, that is one is air seasoning and then another one is water seasoning. These are the two methods. Let's start with the air seasoning. What we do in air seasoning? We provide a platform at the bottom of near about 300 mm, or to say 30 cm of height. Then over that, we we generally check the timber timber block, as well as we provide some of the blocks in between so that their circulation can be provided properly. We generally reduce the moisture content up to 15% in this. Can be understood with the help of this diagram properly. We are doing there this thing. Here we can see this is the fact, this is the ground floor. Over this ground floor we have provided a platform, and the height of this platform is 30 cm or is it 300 meter. Over this 30 cm we have provided this platform. Then we have kept these are the spacers, or these are some of the block, these are some of the blocks. Over this block we have kept, this is nothing but the timber. This is nothing but the timber. Over this block we have kept this timber. Then again we have kept these spacers here. Again we kept one more timber bark over it, then again spacer, again timber, again spacer, again timber, spacer and timber. So what we are doing, we are providing this will be what? This area, this will be open area, this will be the open area. So the purpose of providing this open area is for air circulation, so that there will be drying of the timber from all the sides, and there will be, we can get the uniform degree of drying. This is what the air seasoning. Then we have water seasoning. In the water seasoning, what we usually do? In water seasoning, what we do? Suppose this is a river, water is flowing in this direction. This is a river, water is flowing in this direction. We will keep a thickened area of the timber against the stream of the water. So that what will happen, as due to this law of water, some slack is available on this side of the timber, that will be washed out with the help of this, that will be washed out due to this law of water, as we have kept the timber block against the current of water, against the current. So due to this law of water, this slack which is accumulated on this side, it will be washed out. And once this slab will be washed out, after that, with the help of this air seasoning, after that, what the method we have followed in air seasoning, that by adopting that kind of method or by providing free air circulation, we can reduce the moisture content within this timber. After that, after this natural seasoning, we have the artificial seasoning. In the artificial seasoning, what we do, we keep the timber in within a controlled chamber where we can control the humidity, air circulation as well as temperature, so we can reduce the moisture content within the timber. Here we have the four methods in this artificial seasoning, that is what we have. First one is boiling method, then we have kiln seasoning, then we have chemical seasoning, and then we have electrical seasoning. These are the four methods what we adopt in the artificial seasoning. Let's learn first of all what is the boiling method. In this boiling method, what we are doing in this boiling method? In this method, timber is immersed into the water, and then water is boiled for a duration of 3 to 4 hours. What is the purpose of doing so? If during the felling of tree, sometimes the slab is accumulated on the timber, on the side of timber. So we want to remove that slab from the timber. So for that purpose, what we are doing, we are the timber is immersed into the water and it is boiled for a duration of 3 to 4 hours. So after boiling this, that extra sap will be removed from it, and then we will dry it slowly. Instead of boiling directly within the water, sometimes we adopt the steam method also. And instead, so due to the hot steam also, that sap will be removed after some duration of time. And then this due to air circulation method or by any other method, then we will try to reduce the moisture content from the timber. But this process, in this method, the seasoning, that is the reduction moisture content, this process is fast, but this is a very costly method, as we have to boil and we have to remove the slab first. So this is the costlier method. Then we have the kiln seasoning. Most of times, the kiln seasoning is adopted. In case of the artificial seasoning, what we generally do in this, the kiln is, in this we are generally use a kiln. The kiln is nothing but just a airtight chamber. So in this timber, it is kept into this kiln, and where the temperature is maintained in between the 35 degree centigrade to 38 degree centigrade. And then heat gradually as we have kept the temperature within the skin and the temperature is maintained in between 35 degrees centigrade to 38 degrees centigrade, the heat will gradually reaches inside the chamber. So there will be gradual loss in the moisture. So we can get a gradual degree of seasoning. Then the relative humidity is gradually reduced. As the heating is reaching inside the chamber, the relative humidity will reduce and then temperature will further increase. The end this will be maintained till we will get desired and this process will be maintained till we will get the desired degree of moisture content. The kiln is generally here kiln used method especially or progressive kind of. Here means suppose this is the kiln where we have kept the wooden log. So here we have two types of either this wooden log will be especially at one point or sometime this will be this move this will be continuous progression means the position of this wooden log will change from time to time. This will move in this direction and again it will move in this direction and again it will move forward, again it will move the backward. So the kiln used may be a kind of stationary or it may be the progressive kind of. If you are using the progressive kiln, then the carrier carrying the timber travels from one end to another end of kiln to another end of the kiln and the hot air supplied from the discharging end so that the temperature increases gradually and charging end to discharging end. This method is used for seasoning on a larger scale. Then we have the chemical seasoning. What is regular chemical seasoning? In this method, the timber is immersed into the solution of suitable salt so that the timber is dried in a, and after that timber is dried in a kiln. Why we are immersing into some solution? If some step is available on that and we want to remove the step from that wooden log, so for that particular purpose also, we generally keep the timber into the chemical seasoning. Other than that, if the moisture content is so high, then we generally we can get uniform degree of seasoning. It will be the moisture content in some portion will reduce up to certain level, but in some other part of timber we will not get that much content of. But in some other part of the timber, the moisture content will be something else. So to get the uniform degree of seasoning or the uniform degree of decant moisture content also, for this purpose also we generally soak or we immerse the timber in chemical solution. And after immersing into chemical solution, again we generally follow the same procedure or we generally follow the kiln seasoning for the reduction in moisture content. Then the last one we have the electrical seasoning. In the electrical seasoning, what we do in this method, the high frequency alternate current, that is AC current, is generally passed from the timber. We know that the moisture is that we know that moisture is good conductor of current. So as there will be moisture, as there will be moisture available in the timber, we try to pass the high frequency AC current from this timber. So that at the once it is having the higher moisture content, the further thing, the resistance against this electric current will be very less. But as the current will pass gradually, the moisture content will reduce within the timber. So as the moisture content will reduce, resistance against the electric current will increase. So as the moisture content will reduce, the resistance against the current will increase. So this will say, this can be taken as the measure for stopping the seasoning. So accordingly we will try to get the particular degree of seasoning. We generally use this method also, but this method is a very costly method, but this technique has been tried in some of the plywood industry but not in seasoning of timber on a mass scale, as it is very costlier method as well as risky method also.